Well, welcome everybody. You join us here for our coverage of what is set to be a truly exciting final. Formalities are underway. Everybody is soaking up an energetic, highly charged atmosphere within the ground. The teams will be with us very shortly. We look forward, of course, to that special moment. In the meantime, we take in the feeling of excitement and euphoria ahead of what should be a really outstanding final. Certainly, this is a very, very impressive venue. Quite a sight to behold. And we rise now for the English national anthem. Two teams, Jim Beglin, with one common thought: to have their names on this famous trophy.
Yes, Peter, I've been a winning finalist and I've been a losing finalist, and I don't need to tell anyone what I preferred. Winning will help fans remember you for a long, long time, so I sincerely wish both teams well and hope that all the players can give a good account of themselves, and you've heard it before, may the best team do it.
Action has already started. Look, we can only hope for a final that will be free-flowing, end-to-end and highly entertaining, but fear of defeat can often dominate emotions, so don't be surprised if it gets nervy and tense.
Shaqiri
hits one!
Albeit from an unexpected source.
Well, they say that your front lads should be that first line of stopping the opposition. I think he's taken it to another level with his desire to get back and help everyone out.
Fabinho.
Liverpool can't make any sort of inroad despite all this possession. Anything noteworthy in the early part of the match, Jim?
It's Mane. Mane.
Oh, that's neat. Chance! The shot's on! Liverpool gets good distance on it.
Shaqiri.
Needs to get it forward quickly.
Van Dijk. So it is still 0-0. And it's Mane.
And the shot! There's a goal! That could turn out to be a big, big goal.
Well, you know, thinking about that, I think they've perfected that on the training ground, because it took them seconds to get the ball from back to front, and they really commit forward in numbers too. It was all very well drilled.
Big occasion, big goal, crucial lead.
Well, Peter, the emphasis should now switch to winning it rather than even thinking about losing it.
Mesut Ozil. Hector Bellerin.
Arsenal have pushed both fullbacks into quite advanced positions here.
Just the goalkeeper to shoot! And the second time! It's in!
Arsenal are level!
That's no fluke, it's what he was there for.
Well, as I say, Peter, if you don't speculate, you won't accumulate. We just witnessed a player who was rewarded for his willingness to take a risk, as cunning as it comes.
That has certainly made things interesting.
Yeah, it's always a dangerous time when you've just scored. You can easily lose focus and then bang, you take back again.
It's Clive. And the counter is on.
Going through.
Aubameyang.
Well played, he saw that coming.
Jordan Henderson.
Fabinho. 15 minutes till half-time.
It's Roberto Firmino. He's had a go!
Well, to put it this way, he's probably made better decisions.
Monreal.
There's a long ball. They're guilty of lacking inventiveness here. It's all broken down.
Fabinho.
Jordan Henderson.
That's the through ball. Face to face with the keeper.
Defending was physical, no nonsense,
and it had to be.
Out wide to the right.
It's Hector Bellerin.
That's Ozil.
Mesut Ozil.
And he's whipped it in low.
He's lifting it over.
It's been taken straight back.
Shaqiri.
That's been intercepted.
And that will come to nothing.
Loose ball. Who's going to get there? Keeper's got good distance on that.
And Dyke as well there.
Alert.
Over to the left.
He's in. Looking to shoot. That's a half-decent try. Right.
This is gone, and we've reached the halfway point of the final. Genuinely interesting game here, very, very watchable. Two goals, one each.
So, Jim, the halfway point of the final, what are you thinking?
Our first half that expectations are made of, and the final that is ebbing and flowing with two teams that are willing to throw everything they've got at this. It's a treat for me.
Qatarian with the foul. Fabinho.
Forward it goes.
Mane.
Mane! Trying. The outcome could so easily have been different.
Mane did give it a fair old crack, and he'll be encouraged to step up again.
It's Aubameyang. Fabinho gets it out.
Gomez.
Van Dijk.
Robertson.
Van Dijk.
Gomez.
Fabinho.
Jordan Henderson.
Van Dijk.
Robertson.
The ball's come loose and the chase is on. Can he deliver?
Mane.
Salah has made his impact already.
He's gone for goal!
He's done very well to get to that.
Fabinho simply didn't do anything wrong. He was thwarted by brilliance.
Gets up to head it!
Went with his head, but couldn't steer it in.
to the right. Not much subtlety, he's launched himself there.
Liverpool for a free kick.
This defence just doesn't trust itself to play a higher line.
Frighten the people getting in behind.
Yeah, absolutely. It just opens up the opportunity of not only strikers getting behind, but the runners from midfield too.
Keeper's ball.
That's a foul. Super decision for the referee. Aubameyang sprints it towards the left. Granit Xhaka. And it's Monreal. Looks to clip it forward.
Well back. Hoists it high.
Mohamed Salah.
He is now the subject of some adhesive marking. Yeah, and the fact that he's registered, Peter, simply encourages more attention of a closer nature.
Receives it from behind. Socrates can hoist it clear. Mesut Ozil.
It's got through to him.
He's left his man.
Welbeck
is on his own.
It's a very good battle there. Terrific to watch. Tries to dink it in. But goes for goal. It's there. And the comeback is complete.
That defence just wasn't expecting their midfield to mess up then, so when they did, they were caught completely cold by such a swift breaker and such a well-worked finish too.
So we have a breakthrough.
Yeah, for me this team seems to find it easier to attack than defend, but now they're going to need to dig in at the back of it.
That's Roberto Firmino.
Come back to haunt them.
Mane nearly produced the perfect retort. That can only be a means to have another go.
There's some activity down on the touchline. It seems there's going to...
That's it!
Danger averted for now.
Keep calm and carry on. That's the job in a nutshell now.
Check.
Liverpool can be highly satisfied with such a forceful response to try and get back on equal terms, but they need a hero right now, someone to step up and convert. They're creating the chances.
Obama
going for goal! Really well taken goal! A two-goal lead and they're firmly in control. Lovely goal, perfect poise to set himself for the strike.
Arsenal two up and into a position of real strength.
Well, unsurprisingly, Peter, the opposition looked completely...
He's gone for it! We've got a goal! And what a climax we have here!
Really outwitted one-on-one. Once more, he gets the better of the keeper.
Oh, that's excellent composure, because the keeper put as much pressure on as he could by not committing sooner.
Liverpool making consecutive changes here.
Well, for me, this was the obvious substitution. He'd become just a little jaded, and as a result of that, he was most likely to make a mistake. I think sometimes when the body becomes tired, the brain goes with it. I think that's happened in this case.
Liverpool give themselves a chance of a fairy tale finish. He's got away.
And he's there to hoof it away.
And Dyke with the challenge, and he has given away a free kick.
And no surprise, that's a booking.
Granit Xhaka. He's looked long this time.
The final whistle. Liverpool all at the final hurdle. And he gave it everything, but it was a bridge too far. And so it ends in pain as the glory goes elsewhere. So much endeavour, so much expectation, so little ultimate reward.
And these boys will be absolutely devastated. There's nothing worse than that losing feeling. I've been there, and believe me, it hurts.